Hello, 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 everyone.
Hi, everyone. You are tuning to Normals. I'd like to
show appreciation to every single 523 subscriber that we have. It means a lot to us, man. We really appreciate that.
Just the point of correction, it's 528 subscribers that you're actually sitting on, man. I'm really grateful for that. Really grateful for everyone that actually subscribed to this channel. So now today's topic is that, what or how many properties do I actually need to become financially free? This is one question that I actually asked myself when I started that, okay, now that I'm going into the property industry, how many properties do I need to have to be financially free?
I mean, this is one of the frequent questions that has been coming through us, as we did say that this is not just a YouTube channel. What we want to do is want to get optimum results out of this. So we have been connecting with property investors. So one of the frequent questions that has come up is, how many properties do I need to actually become financially free? And I mean, once you start asking yourself that question, that's when you can see that you are trying to build a portfolio, or you are looking at this in terms of sustainability instead of an investment whereby I can get rich quick.
Let's go in, man. Let's go in, right? So now this is going to be a different one from what we've actually used to, right? Tell us if you actually like it. If you like it, please post down below, right? If you like the way we conducted this, please do comment down below, right? So now let me ask you, Neo, what is, before we actually see how many properties we need to actually first understand the concept financially free, right? True. So now what does financial freedom mean to you?
I mean, financial freedom to me means that I can financially sustain my lifestyle without having stress.
Financial freedom to me means that I'm able to sit at home without worrying about anything, right? Be it anything that happens to me, money will still be coming into my account.
I mean, when we speak about financial freedom with property, one thing comes to my mind, renting multi-let, which is the end goal of our journey. What you need to do is that when you want to run property as a business, when you want to run property the right way, is that you need to ask yourself, where do you need to go? Where am I right now and where do I need to go? And of course, I'm sure for everybody, financial freedom is there. So now with us, we already know that rental is the strategy that will get us there.
Okay, for me, financial freedom in terms of flipping properties, it doesn't actually make sense, right? So now for me, financial freedom is that even if I were to stop flipping houses, right? I've stopped flipping houses. If I was to stop flipping houses, would I actually get money cash flowing into my bank account, right? That's financial freedom for me. So now financial freedom, building financial wealth, actually goes to more of the renting side. The flip strategy is to actually have a lot of money in my pocket, right? But now in order for me to actually create that generational wealth, non-wealth, that we're always talking about, right? That I can actually give towards my children if they're not interested. I mean, my partner says that what happens if I have built this mega business, right? Mm-hmm. That we've built this mega business. Am I actually going to force it towards my children, right? And the answer is that if I have actually built, right, property in a way whereby it doesn't need me or anyone to actually sustain it, it becomes more of getting passive income, right, without actually having to do anything, right? All I just need to do is to go to the property, say once a month, to see if everything is actually going well. And if I actually put in someone that is a best at managing properties, that will actually work at my benefit.
Okay, let me hit the second nerve. With what you said right now is that I heard that sustainability is the key term, with summarizing what you said. Now, with sustainability, what I'd like to emphasize on, when you said that you don't have passive income, I know there's this thing of everybody wanting, or not everybody, I know there's this notion of passive income, I don't have to do anything, but you need to understand what happened behind the curtains, what happened behind the closed doors, the hours that you took with regards to getting this content that you have right now, the hours that you took in terms of getting the experiences, getting burnt, learning from your previous mistakes and going forward. So with passive income, there's a whole lot of work that comes with it. Mm-hmm. I'd like to emphasize that even with financial freedom is not just a term, like, man, I'm going to be financial free by tomorrow. Freedom itself comes with, when you hear the word freedom, you know that somebody fought for it. Mm-hmm. There was a whole sacrifice that happened for it. So with property, it's about doing it the right way. So we always, I'm sure our network knows this, we always talking about building it as a business. How am I going to build financial freedom as a business whereby I'll be able to sustain myself? So what I'll do is that I'll look at my expenses and I know that I'll need 10,000 to actually sustain myself. And then I know I'm going to be looking for a property worth 10 that will give me 10,000 net. However, now the challenge comes here. If it's a single let and there's one person living there, it's not a problem for others, but it's a problem for others, for other investors. It depends on
the situation. For me, it is a problem.
Hence, I said for others. I know you. So now what will happen is that you are going to take it as a high risk in terms of if this person doesn't pay or if this person leaves or my management company doesn't necessarily cover that cost, it will be a problem towards that sustainability that we're talking about and financial freedom. So it has to be done in a way that will be, that is very thorough, guys. There's a whole lot of work that goes in it. Hence, I emphasize that there's a lot that happens with regards to financial freedom in property.
And now remember, even after acquiring that property, right, there are still those minor things that you have to do on a monthly basis, right? Like collecting all the property reports that you have in that particular property. Say, for instance, the expenses that you actually had to encounter in terms of your levies, your rates and taxes, the bond that you actually had to do, right? To actually collect all of that data and put it into what's one... into a spreadsheet, right, to actually send to your accountant. That's actually work that you have to do. But now looking at that type of work and the labor intensive work that we have to do all day, every day, I mean, I'll choose the data capturing every month, every day I'll choose it.
Well, financial freedom, as we did mention, it's more of sustainability, right? So how do we do it the right way from the onset? So then if you're asking yourself that question, that means this question will be relative from one person to another. Somebody will be saying, for instance, if I say that the only amount that I need to sustain my lifestyle right now is 10,000 or 50,000, that means, okay, let's see, let's use 50,000. If I know that to sustain, because I know that you're very expensive. So to sustain your lifestyle for this month, it's 50,000. You'll need 50,000. What we'll do is that, okay, how about we look for rental units that will bring us a net of 50,000? How am I going to work that out? I can look for them on Property 24, or I can call. We did talk about having a power team. So the power team will help me get so many units at this price. And then what I need to do right now, as we did highlight the importance of educating yourself and strategically positioning yourself in a position whereby you can take strategic measures, whereby you're working from the end goal. The end goal, how are you working with the end goal? I know that I have to get 50,000. Let's say to sustain us, to sustain our lifestyle on a monthly basis was 10,000. If I add all my expenses, it reaches 10,000. So I know that if I want to be financially free in this regard, I need to get 10,000 every month.
Okay.
So with rent, as we did say, rent and running it like a business. So it's going to happen. I'm going to call an estate agent. Hey man, ring me up if you find such a deal that you can get a net of 10,000. And then the estate agent called me like, hey man, guess what? I got a deal for you. It generates a gross of 20,000 monthly on a monthly basis. And then looking at your expenses, if you run all your expenses, you'll rather run at about 9.5. So now it's up to me, can I take this thing or not? Or if I was somebody who was working and I was earning something like 30,000, and then I know that this amount is the money that set me free, I'm sorted if I can just get this 30,000. What you need to do then is calculate that, okay, how can I get properties that will give me a net, emphasis on a net of that amount indicated.
Definitely. If I can just explain something, right? If you do not understand what net is the profit that you get, right? So now say, for instance, the example that Noah did, right? So now the amount that actually comes towards me is 20,000, right? But remember, we have the monthly expenses that we actually need to pay. So now we have 20,000 right here, right? After this 20,000, you need to minus all of your expenses. Say they all reach up to a 10,000, right? 10,000. So now your net amount would be what? Would be the remaining 10,000. So now the remaining amount after all your expenses have been taken off, that would be your net amount.
Guys, if I could give you a practical example how people make mistakes in property. You'll find a property whereby the rental income is 10,000. So the estate agent calls us, hey man, the rental income is 10,000. And then we find that the bond is 9,000. Only to find out that we've got levies that we need to factor in. And we've got insurance and we've got management fees. So at the end, we are actually running at a loss. And it's going to become a problem. Let me tell you why I'm saying that it's going to become a problem. Non-wealth treats property just as a business. So that means if we are not making money from this property, that means we are bleeding money. We're not making money at all. It's a loss. And if I'm having a business and I'm running at a loss, I need to ask myself something. Am I going to start capitalizing after 20 years or am I going to start? What do I need to do? And if that's the case, that means the next 20 years, I need to be realistic and practical with myself that I'll be not making money. And we cannot afford to find ourselves in that situation because we're treating this as a business. That means we need to make sure that it cash flows. How do we do that? With a set of skills that we did, as I did mention, it's very important, guys. I will not underplay this. It's very important to invest in yourself so that you can strategically position yourself and take strategic measures with regards to finding investment portfolios that will cash flow positive.
And remember, in all that we're doing, right, in our daily grind that we actually go through every day, right, the main goal is to get to that point whereby now I'm financially free, right? Now I'm no more on survival. I think the tone, did you notice that my tone went down?
Why?
This is a very sensitive topic, right?
Sure.
To a point whereby everything is now able to run itself, and then the money that you're actually getting from your salary, you can use it for whatever you want, right? Because now the last thing that you want is that now that your salary has been chopped off, right, and now you are forced to downscale, right? So now you go back to a point whereby now you're on survival mode. Survival mode is not the best place to be. You want to be at that point whereby right now, even if I get fired at work, I'm still having the same lifestyle that I actually have right now. All I just need to do is actually grow my passive income, right? So now that's what we're actually looking forward to in our financial freedom.
Guys, answering this question, we are asking a question by answering this question. How so? You need to sit down on a spreadsheet and write down that. You need to sit down and write on a spreadsheet that this is the amount that I need to be financially free. As we did say, it's relative from one person to another.
Mm-hmm.
And once you find out that amount, therefore you know that how much net you will need to sustain this question. And then you will know that's the end goal that you're actually working towards. And do not be apologetic when it comes to how much do I need to be financially free. You've got the right to say, I need 10 million. I need 100 million. Don't be like and say that you want 10,000. You can say that you want 10 million. There's no cap. There's no cap towards having the amount of properties. However, now if you do it correctly and you're able to scale in a manner that's strategic, it will actually, one property will lead to the next, another one should lead to the next in a sustainable manner so that you can reach the end goal, which is financial freedom.
Hope you actually got a lot of value from this. I like the video. What do you think?
I love it, man. I love it.
Hope you loved it. Hope you please do subscribe, comment, like, and if you watch throughout, you know what to do. Leave us a pro.
As we did say, we appreciate every single one of the 528 subscribers that we have. Let's grow and let's push together. Let's network and share with each other. How can we grow and push towards financial freedom in a strategic manner?